What's up, guys? My name is Zach Golden. I am the head of Golden Guy Pictures. And it's been a long time since we've had another fan film review. I've been very busy with the production of my own Star Wars fan film, The Foretelling, coming out on May 5th. Looking forward to that. It's kept me very busy. Since then, there's been a lot of changes, a lot of exciting things happening. Like, for example, I got a haircut. So, I've been very busy, and I'm glad to finally be able to sit down and make another review with you guys. So for those of you who might be watching me for the first time, I'm not with any kind of film review company like IMDb or Rotten Tomatoes. Like, I am just someone who really enjoys fan films, and I really enjoy movie making as a whole. So what I like to do is I like to sit down, watch these fan films, and kind of talk about them. What were the strong points? What were the weak points? And I have a ranking system where I basically go over the different aspects of film production. And I break it down based on directing, writing, acting, cinematography, soundtrack, set design, location, costuming, VFX, and the last thing that I call the Star Wars factor, which essentially is, by the end of the fan film, how Star Wars is your fan film. And again, like, I'm not in any kind of pedestal. I'm just a fan who enjoys talking about fan films. And the fun part is, by the end of the review, after going through each of the categories and talking about and ranking them, I'll round up all the numbers and I will deliver what I like to call the Rotten Meilu Run score, which is kind of it plays off of the Rotten Tomato score kind of idea, and it's basically just my personal ranking system for fan-released Star Wars properties. So that said, today we will be watching Star Wars Legends: Legacy of the Force. This was a fan film requested to me after my most recent fan film review, and I have never seen this fan film before. Most of the most recent fan films that I've watched, they were films that I had already seen before, so it wasn't really reaction in its character. It was much more of a review. But for this, it's going to be an interesting episode because I will be both reacting and reviewing. So this will be a unique experience for me. Again, I've never seen this fan film before. It came out in 2015. It's got over 1 million views, so it looks like it's done very well. And I'm very interested. From what I've seen, it's like a visualization of the Legacy of the Force novelization that follows Jaina, Jacen, and Anakin Solo. Which, for those of you who don't know, before Disney bought Star Wars, those three characters were the offspring of Han and Leia. And a lot of the inspiration behind Kylo Ren comes from Anakin Solo. So there's a fun fact for you. But I'm really interested to seeing this. It's cool that these people came together and took the novelization to the next level. That nobody will ever, like, I don't think we'll ever see any kind of Legends, specifically Legends content made visually. We might see characters come back into canon from Legends like Thrawn, but I don't think we'll ever get Legends in its purest form on screen like this fan film has done. So it's really cool to see stuff like this made by the fans. All right, so without further ado, let's watch this fan film. Nice. So it looks like they're following the more towards the end of the novelization Legacy of the Force. If I remember correctly. Got some serious Revenge of the Sith vibes. Oh yeah, this is definitely reminiscent of Revenge of the Sith. Oh wow, look at that.
Brother was was right about one thing. He did this to me.
Caedus, my brother Jacen did this to you? Or Fett?
Babu Ear. It was a death mission. He sent us on a death mission. Promise.
If I make it, I promise.
Good. And the last thing. It's easy.
No. Murda, I'm not going to do that. Even if I don't make it, your grandfather...
Gina, it's not for that. When they wake up, I'm going to need a way to keep them quiet. For you.
Good point. Thanks.
You're welcome. Now, the thing about your brother. He underestimates you.
That's not really news, Murda. Maybe not even true. He's stronger in the Force than I am. All I've got on him is the Mandalorian commando training that you and Fett put me through.
And that's enough to get the job done. He's delusional. He's convinced you couldn't have taken his arm. At least not alone. He thinks Luke was with us.
Maybe Luke was there.
He wasn't. I was conscious most of the time and I didn't see him. Now, get out of here. You've only got an hour until my next meds are due.
She looks like Jaina Solo. That's impressive. You look at some of the action figures and art. That's what Jaina Solo looks like.
May the Force be with you, Murda.
Sure, Jedi. Shoot straight and run fast.
This is the way. Darth Caedus. Set design is very impressive.
I wondered why I hadn't been interrogated yet. Obviously, you were saving all the fun for yourself.
It's Caedus now, Prince Isolde. Darth Caedus.
The reason you haven't been interrogated yet has nothing to do with fun. We have other means of locating the Jedi base. So I saw no need to impinge on your dignity.
How very considerate of you. Not what I expected from child stealing scum. You'd already taken Tenelkha's arm. Not that you've fared any better recently. My daughter, Jacen. Her child. How dare you? My granddaughter.
We all make mistakes. I'm sure you'll come to appreciate that time now, if you will please come with me.
I don't think so. Whatever
I wasn't asking. Please don't consider my respect an act of weakness, Prince. That'd be one of those mistakes I just mentioned.
Of course. It seems I'm entirely at your disposal. May I inquire as to where you were taking me?
I'm afraid you'll have to depart during the middle of battle. We've almost broke through. Once you're clear of us, you should be safe enough.
You're releasing me? Why?
Because my only other choice is to kill you. And I'd really rather not.
So I can lead you to the Jedi base?
We already know where the Jedi base is. We'll be jumping to Shadow Mayad as soon as we break free from your daughter's fleet. You'll be free to go anywhere you wish. As long as you don't allow yourself to be captured again.
This is about the Nano Killer, isn't it?
Yes. Cops are rather keen on using it against Tunnel Ka.
You're not as clever as you think you are, Jacen. I'd rather die than fall for your ploy.
I was afraid you'd say that. And death is certainly an option. Joining this crew aboard the beam racer. Tell them they'll have to depart without him.
Sure they will. They're loyal.
Then you have to blow the ship in her berth. And board the hangar when it's done. The nano killers of the utmost priority. We can't afford to take any chances with this.
Look at that. Not very often you see droids.
Captain, I beg your pardon.
Why is this level so vacant? Is the ship in danger?
This level's been cleared. Lord Caedus is bringing another body down here.
Wow, look at those sets. That is just... That's impressive.
Recently, especially any carrying remnant forces.
Sir.
Tell me.
A missile boat just left, sir. We had to wait for it to clear the containment field before we blew the beam racer. A remnant colonel saw the moth. Shall I have a recall order issued?
They won't obey. The moths have betrayed me. Have my stealth vest prepped for immediate... Jaina?
Thank you. That's it? Is that really the end? Man. Okay. Overall, I'd say that was very impressive. I think the most impressive thing about this fan film was definitely the set design. There were times where it really looked like we were watching a scene from Star Wars simply based on what the surroundings were. That hallway looked like it was straight from A New Hope. So I thought that was very impressive. There was a lot of attention to detail with the background, you know, with all the buttons and the crates and all the contraptions and the doorways and, you know, you see the floorboards with the lights coming out, just all that stuff was very well put together. Yeah. Very good job with that. Soundtrack was very cool. The fact that they used their own original work, something you don't see enough of that these days. You know, I wish people put in the extra time, the extra money into putting together their own score, because oftentimes you'll either see two things. You'll either see copyright free Star Wars music, which, you know, is fine. It came from older Star Wars properties that came out way before the Disney buyout, so you see it and you recognize it and it's like, oh, it's okay, you know. And then on the other hand, you have the even worse alternative, which is using some of John Williams's work, which I think is a big no. That's something that just shouldn't be happening in your fan film. Because, you know, you're taking the work of just an absolute legend and you're throwing it into your work, which, you know, this is in no way an insult to independent filmmakers today. But at the same time, it's like, until you have the LC, the platform to be able to hire John Williams for your projects. Sorry if that keeps falling in and out of focus. I don't know why that keeps happening. But until you have the platform to be able to afford John Williams, don't take his work and put it into your fan film. Just don't do it. I, like, to be honest, like, even if your soundtrack isn't that great, the fact that you put in the effort to make your own original score, you automatically earn my respect, because it's like, you recognize that you're not Hollywood, you recognize you're not George Lucas, and you're embracing the fact that you're learning. And so when I see people's original soundtrack, I always respect it. I'm still going to critique it if it's not, you know, where it should be, because how else are we going to grow? But at the same time, you automatically earn my respect if you go out and compose your own soundtrack. That's what they did with Star Wars Legends. I could tell that it wasn't John Williams, but I could also tell that it was someone's original work that they put a lot of hard work into, and they did a great job of hitting the beats, and it all just felt very cohesive. It felt like Star Wars. I think if they used any other kind of sound for their music, it wouldn't have felt like Star Wars. It would have felt something else, like Alien. Like, this almost felt borderline Scott Ridley Alien to me. Like, it could have been that, honestly. If they had some kind of strange alien creature, that's what it would have been. So that was cool. It just felt very vintage, very retro in the way that this Star Wars film was put together. It felt 70s. Like, I felt like I was watching something from the 70s. The acting, here's what I'll say. I'm on the fence in terms of acting. At my first watch, there were times where the acting was very strong, and then other times where the acting was just weak. my favorite moment as far as interactions are concerned is when Darth Caedus is telling Jaina, he's like, we don't have time for this. And then she's like, so die already. And you can see the fury and the passion in each other's eyes. Like, there's obviously this dynamic between these two characters because they're related. They're brother and sister. And yet they've turned on each other, and it's heavy, and you can see the weight in their eyes. But then in the other moments, the other scenes where, you know, the dialogue or just the things happening in the story, when it's not as important, you don't see a whole lot happening with the actors, which kind of bums me out because I see these actors and I'm like, man, these people have a lot of potential. And so it was hit and miss. As far as the directing is concerned, I have to commend the director because he did a good job of Caedus and Jaina and how they treated each other, how they interacted. How it was the combination of, you know, having to balance that sibling hatred with passion is difficult to accomplish on screen, and I felt he did a good job of it. But again, hit and miss. But the rest of the fan film, the director did an amazing job. Like I said, it felt like something from the 70s, like a Star Wars property from the 70s. He did a great job. What else? Let's see what else we got. VFX, I took a couple of points down at different moments because VFX, I think they bit off a whole lot more than they could chew. The visual effects was just, here's the best way to describe it. Where the movie felt like it came from the 70s, the visual effects also looked like it came from like the 80s, 90s. A bit rough, and that's unfortunate because it's always something that kind of pulls you out of the story when things unfortunately don't look realistic enough. You know, like, and I've got to be completely honest, when we first left the opening crawl and we panned towards the space shot, I had no idea what I was looking at. I really didn't. I didn't know if that was space or like if we were on some kind of strange planet. It really wasn't until I saw the asteroids like moving and then the Star Destroyer coming out that I was like, oh, wow, okay, so this is space. So, you know, in most areas, if it looks bad but you recognize what it is, at least you understand your surroundings. Unfortunately for this fan film, I had a lot of trouble grasping what I was looking at in the opening scene. And then you had other shots where the green screen was very obvious. But at the same time, I didn't get too jarred simply because I knew what I was looking at. So I took a couple of points off for VFX. Writing is also something I want to kind of nitpick here for a little bit. So with Star Wars, what you notice in every single one of the films, whether it's Disney or George's work, it always, 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 always opens with an action scene. And this one did as well. And so as soon as it opened with the fight scene, I was like, okay, yes, this feels like Revenge of the Sith. I'm loving this. This looks great. And then she lands onto the Star Destroyer and we get introduced to the Jaina and the character that's there with her, and they start talking about this previous battle and this, you know, this thing where the girl gets paralyzed and it seems like it's Caedus' fault, but it also seems like it's Fett's fault, and there's these terrible things happening, and it's been a long time since I've, you know, kept up with my Darth Caedus Jaina Solo lore. It's been a while since I've read up on the Wikipedia, so as someone who has even read the material and went in watching this fan film, I was lost. I was a bit confused on what what was happening. Like, I couldn't quite follow as hard as I tried to remember everything. And so I can't even imagine what it would be like for someone who's never read the Legends material and tries to watch this fan film. Like, I would almost not recommend this to people who have not caught up with any kind of Star Wars Legends material. And just simply because they don't understand the context. They don't understand who Jaina is or who Caedus is. Like, watching this fan film, I'd be like, Jaina Solo? Is she related to Han and Leia? How are they related? And, you know, so that was something I kind of was a little disappointed with, was like, if you're going to make a fan film about legacy of the Force, if you're going to bring in legends, if you're going to have a story about Darth Caedus, Anakin Solo, and Jaina Solo, we need Han and Leia to be intricate parts of this fan film. Like, we almost need those characters to appear. Because you know, when you're making a fan film, you don't want to limit your audience to the big nerds, the big sweats. I mean, you can if you want, but you're just gonna limit yourself. Now, if you create a property that anyone can enjoy, you're obviously gonna get a much bigger audience of people who enjoy it, who understand it, who like it. And now, I mean, regardless, obviously these people have racked in a ton of views. But I think, you know, once again, they were almost there. They were almost there with the visual effects. They were almost there with the acting, and they were almost there with the writing. I don't think they should have started the fan film when it started. We needed to have some kind of further development of who Jaina, Caedus, and Anakin are. Like, the great thing about the opening crawl in Star Wars films is that you can lay out a context, but there's only so much you can accomplish with those. If you watch all of the Skywalker Saga Star Wars films, you notice that the opening crawls give out context, they lay the groundwork, but they don't give these massive details. Unless you want to look at the sequel trilogy, where the very first words in The Force Awakens is Luke Skywalker has gone missing. We're all just like, whoa, you know, where'd that come from? You know, like, so it would have been nice if we would have actually seen that before we were told in the opening crawl. So for this fan film, it simply would have been better. It would have made things easier for people to follow if the opening crawl laid out just the simple context of the situation, and then you implement the most important aspects of these characters and this story into the fan film. So that was my issue with the beginning of Legacy of the Force, and the same problem applies to the end of the fan film. Because here's the truth, here's the fact about Star Wars, is that regardless of what you make in a Star Wars fan film, or just a Star Wars film period, whether it's Disney-owned, Lucasfilms, or your work, if you are going to make a Star Wars property, it has to be for kids, it has to be hopeful, and it has to be Star Wars. You know what I'm saying? So, first of all, you guys hit the marks with making it feel like Star Wars. I've already explained that. You did a very good job. It has to be for kids, and I argue that this is something that kids could definitely watch. I didn't feel like there were anything that was too dark or adulty. I felt like, you know, this was something that I would be perfectly okay with my 5, 10, 12-year-old kid to watch if I had kids. I don't have kids. Sad day. So it's definitely Star Wars. It's definitely for kids. But I did not feel hopeful at the end. And that is a big deal with Star Wars. You have to feel hopeful at the end of every single Star Wars movie, every single Star Wars episode, whether it's The Mandalorian or Rebels or Clone Wars. If you don't feel hopeful at the end of the property, then something is wrong with your material. And I did not feel hopeful at the end of this fan film. I was almost like thrown off. I was like, wait, is this really where we're going to close this fan film? Like it's almost a little disappointing because you had these people come together that were passionate about Star Wars, had the means and the resources to put together this fan film that obviously, like, you can see the passion and the hard work that all these people put into, and then you're just gonna end it on a note like that? I don't even, we didn't get to meet Tenelle Kaw or her daughter, and that would have been something that we should have seen. Like, if Darth Caedus really cared so much about these characters, where are they? Why can't we see them? Why can't we meet them? And, you know, Jaina kills her brother, and then roll credits? I mean, that is a hard thing to pull off without it not seeming like Star Wars. Like, killing your own sibling, that does things to a person. What did it do to Jaina? I mean, obviously, if you know your sources, you know the books, you've read them, then, okay, you're gonna know what happens to the characters. But for me, who's only read it once, and, you know, that was like 5 years ago, and for other people who aren't familiar with Legends, they're gonna have no idea what happens to Jaina. They're gonna have no idea what this does to affect Tenelle Kaw or Alana. What does this do for the Republic or the Imperial Remnants? Like, what kind of effect does this have? And I really think they should have added an extra 5-10 minutes to just wrap things up. You know, maybe not continue right after the death, but maybe jump to the end of the story where we see who Tenelle Kaw becomes, we see who Jaina Solo becomes, and we just kind of wrap things up after the legacy of Darth Caedus's death. I think it was very, very bold to end on that note, and unfortunately, I don't think it hits the mark that they were hoping for. So I took points off for that. I'm done with my nitpicking. Although I do want to say the droid was impressive. When I saw the droid, I was very impressed because you don't see droids or aliens very often in fan films. So anytime I see it, I'm like, okay, that's impressive. That's really cool. That makes it feel all the more cohesive with that galaxy far, far away. So tons of respect for the droid being in there. That said, there were moments where you could tell it was a costume, and I took points off for that. But regardless, if you have the resources, if you have the means to put in droids, aliens, anything like that in your Star Wars film, do it. It shouldn't even matter if it doesn't look perfect. The fact that it's in there is going to convince audiences even more that what you have is Star Wars. Good job with that, guys. I commend you for all the work you've done. With that said, I'm going to look over these notes, round up the numbers, and I will come back to you with the Rotten Melu Run score for Star Wars Legends Legacy of the Force. Okay, so Star Wars Legends Legacy of the Force walks away with a Rotten Melu Run score of 78%. Very entertaining. It felt very Star Wars in a lot of places. Ultimately, though, the writing, the VFX kind of fell short. The acting was hit and miss. And I did not feel very hopeful at the end of the fan film, which is something that always needs to happen in your Star Wars fan films. If you are wanting to make a Star Wars fan film, regardless of what your story is going to be about, the ending has to be hopeful on one level or another. But other than that, they had their own original soundtrack, which is always impressive. The acting had its moments where it was very strong, and the set design is probably the best I have ever seen in any fan film, period. They really set the bar for what set design should be in Star Wars fan films. So good job with that, guys. And I want to see more of these people. Like, I want to know if they've done more things. Let me look this up real quick. Yeah, it looks like they've come out with another fan film since then. It looks like the name of their YouTube is literally just fan film. Unless this is like some kind of fake person on YouTube stealing their work or something. Hopefully that's not the case. But cool, yeah, I'm gonna check out more of their work. I'm subscribing as we speak. Y'all should too. At the end of the day, you all need to be supporting anyone who makes fan films, because I really do think that's the future, is more freelance, independent artists just completely taking over Hollywood and the movie business. I think independent filmmakers is the future, and I think Star Wars has a very, very bright future ahead of them. Now that they've got people like Jon Favreau, Dave Filoni, Deborah Chow, Taika, all those guys like stepping in and putting in work to give people something that's reminiscent of George's vision for Star Wars. So anytime you see a fan film, watch it, hit that like button, subscribe to these people, because they need that kind of attention. They need more of it. So good job, guys, with this amazing fan film. I really enjoyed it. I had my issues with it, but you know what? This came out in 2015. I guarantee these people have learned a few things since then. I know I'm going to learn a lot from you guys when my fan film comes out, The Foretelling. And it's a learning process. Like, that's all filmmaking is. And you know what? Like, if you make something that you're proud of, at the end of the day, what am I going to say that's really going to affect you in the long run? Sure, you can take it to heart if you want, but regardless, if you make something that you're proud of, be proud of it. If you are, like be proud of this fan film, guys. Legacy of the Force is, like, very impressive. It sets the bar for what other Star Wars fan film makers want to accomplish, you know? So be proud of this. Don't take my words the wrong way and think that I'm trashing you guys, because I'm not. Like, I'm very impressed with what you guys put together with this. But again, anytime you make something Star Wars, your goal is to make people feel hopeful at the end. That should always be your number one mission at the end of your production, is how can we make people feel good at the end of this episode? Yes, the good guy won at the end of the fan film. That's great. But what does that mean? I didn't know what it meant for Jaina or Tenelka or Alana. I didn't know what it meant for the Republic or for, you know, the overall battle against good and evil. You know, those are things that have to be explained. You cannot explain all those things in a title crawl. You can lay the groundwork in the title crawl, but as far as big story beats are concerned, tell that visually. Don't throw it on a title crawl, expect me to read it, and then be happy by the end of the fan film. You can't do that. I'm sorry. But beyond that, I'm still like surprised that this is something that came out in 2015, and on top of that, was made by fans. You know, like, this looks like something that was like some kind of classic Star Wars serial that came out in the 70s. Like, that's what it felt like, and that's very impressive, very impressive. So, yeah, if you can capture that same essence and then meet it with writing that is reminiscent of George's work in the sense that you have these foundational aspects of Star Wars that need to remain alive in your properties. If you were to combine those elements with the classic vintage looks that you put together here, you'd have a perfect Star Wars fan film. It'd be perfect, flawless. So that's my advice to you guys. You've definitely taught me some things. What you've taught me through this fan film is that, like, building sets is not too far away. It's not too far away. For a lot of people, that's like, man, there's no way I could afford that. There's no way I could put that together. Why not? Find a way to do it. These people did. These people looked at, I guarantee they sat there looking up ways to build convincing sets at cheap prices. And they found the way. This is the way. All right, so that's all I've got for you guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments if there's a fan film you want me to review or react to. That said, I will see you next time in the next episode of Fan Film Reviews. May the Force be with you, always.